All right, so here's the syllabus for this class. You can find the syllabus right there. CIT 15, Computer Concepts. Here's how you get in touch with me. Once again, important, you must enroll in my IT lab by that date, otherwise you'll be dropped from the class or be given an F. You saw how to buy the course materials. Here's the course ID for my IT lab. I spelled that wrong. And you enter that course ID, you saw how to do that in the last video. Course objective, student grading. Half your grade comes from my IT lab, half of your grade comes from Canvas. So the work that you do in Canvas, that's half your grade. The work you do in my IT lab, that's half your grade. And, you know, some examples, if you had like 80% in my IT, in Canvas, and my IT lab was 100%, you know, you have earned, this somehow got flipped around. But you have earned, you know, half of 80 is 40, half of 100 is 50. Add those together, you have 90 in the class. So I guess I'll fix that. Flip around, edit. And bring that to the top. That makes more sense, right? That's weird that that got somehow dropped to the bottom. But that's the calculation we want. Right? Update the syllabus. And that's pretty much all you need to know about your grade. The final will be available online. Due dates. So if you're in the online class, then you have to do discussions, and those have to be done before I grade them, which is usually before the end of the week, say one every week. Otherwise, you just have to do everything before the semester ends. You can do it all in the first 2 weeks. You could do it all in the last 2 weeks, which I don't recommend. Or you could do a little bit each week. I've structured it, so if you're going to stay on pace with the class, here's what you should do week one, here's what you should do week two, here's what you should do week three. And but it's your choice. I've had some students finish all the work in the class in like the first 2 weeks. And then they calculate their grade and they realize that attendance is like, you know, X percent. And they're like, sweet, I don't have to come anymore after spring break and I have an A. It's your choice. It's different than other classes. Most other classes are really structured. Here's the deadline. If you miss it, you get this much off. I don't want all that complication. I'm your boss. I'm results oriented. Get this done by this date. If you do a good job, you'll continue to be employed. If you don't, I'm going to fire you. Have fun. Except in here, it's if you do a good job, you'll get an A. If you don't, you'll get an F. Look and see, make sure that camera's on and cool, I am recording. So that's it. You just have to have everything done by that first week. So here we have announcements, syllabus, and we have assignments. And if you look at the assignments, that spirit of adventure and exploration, here's all the week one stuff. Here's all the week two stuff. Here's all the week three stuff. Sweet, right? There might be a way to sort these. Edit, delete, that's my side. Add, you know, maybe there's a way for you to sort. No, group, great. All right, that's it. So just listed by weeks. Week one, you got a lot of stuff to do. Upload a picture. You got to take a picture of yourself and upload it. Take a screenshot, right? Oh, that's a screenshot. How many people know what a screenshot is? Raise your hand. Stand up if you know what a screenshot is. I like having people stand up because for some reason, like people are more motivated. Thank you. For some reason, people are more motivated. You can sit down. For everybody standing, go outside. I just want to talk to the people who are sitting here. For some reason, people like won't raise their hand, but then when I say stand up, they're like, well, I don't want to be left out. He might kick everybody out that's standing up. And I'm going to have to talk to him about how I don't have to make a screenshot. All right, I'll stand up. But I ask people to raise their hand, like only 8 hands go up. Why? Why? Seriously, why?
Maybe because they're waiting to see everybody else's hands. Who does and who doesn't.
But they get lazy and they just
do it.
You don't
see. Maybe, yeah, like my hands up. It's interesting. So a screenshot is like, here's what's on my screen, and maybe I want to show something. I can say this right here, look at that. And I take a picture of it, and then I have that picture. Well, that's not it. I have that picture somewhere on my desktop. What time is it? It's 9:52, 7:36, right there. I have that picture right there on my desktop. That's a screenshot. It even says screenshot. So how do you do that? Well, let's go do the screenshot assignment. Take a screenshot, blah, 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 YouTube video.
So now we're going to do how to take a screenshot. And the way you do that, I want to teach you how to solve problems, not just show you how to solve a problem. And
so you watch the video, then you do it, and then you upload the proof. And then you do the next one. And so this first week, I front load my course. Meaning, wow, man, this class is going to seem heavy the first week. Second week, third week, front load it. Right? And then like the last 5 weeks, it's going to be easy. Last third of the semester, easy. Why? What do all other classes do? They backload it, right? Last 6 weeks of the other classes. So my class, I try to do the exact opposite of what everybody else is doing. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15. 16, 17, 18, 19. You have 19 assignments this first week. But they're all really quick, like taking a screenshot. And they're all real skill-oriented. Like, man, here's some fundamental skills about using computers that you should totally know. Like anonymous browsing. I don't know where or if we talk about VPNs. I think in the privacy section we'll talk about that. But anonymous browsing, good to know about. Right? Be a little bit anonymous. Two-step authentication, good to know about if you aren't already dialed in. And if you are, then you understand, you like know the terminology to talk about it. Super cool. So that's assignments. And you can come in here and you can see your grade for Canvas, which is half your grade. My IT lab's the other half. Add them together, divide by 2, that's your grade in the class. So don't look in here and think, oh, cool, I already know what I have in the class. No, that's just for Canvas. And then people, pages, whatever, you can look at those, chat, online tutoring, files, attendance. I'll take attendance. That's it for Canvas.
So when's the due date for the week 1 activity?
Somebody answer that question.
No due date.
No due date. Right, before the semester's over. When do you want it to be? You want to wait till the last 2 weeks, or you want to get like a whole bunch of stuff done the first 2 weeks? Like, man, I just sit down this weekend and work 6 hours on Saturday, work 6 hours on Sunday, and see how far I could go. And then do that like every day and try to finish this class in 2 weeks? How awesome would that be? Or maybe, you know, if you're good with it, or maybe it's like, no, my approach is going to be I want to pace myself and drip it to myself over time so it sticks more instead of powering through it all and then I did it all but I don't remember any of it. So you get to choose. So that's Canvas, and then we'll go to My IT Lab. And once you're all signed up, you'll click sign in, and then you'll go into the class. And I'm not a super huge fan of my IT lab. It's required that we use it. So I have to use it. All the classes have to use it. It's a little bit buggy. So sometimes you'll hit questions that just don't work. But I've set this up so that you could take it as many times as you want. So if something doesn't work, just take it again. And you have little modules. So here are the course materials. Inside here is the e-textbook, right? So here's the e-textbook. So Technology in Action, 14th edition. So you could go in there and probably Command F through that to find whatever question. If there's a question, like, oh, what is this? You could Command F, find it in the textbook, go back, answer the question. How many people that Command F is new to you? Sweet, right? Like, that's awesome. And here are the textbook PowerPoints. And so Technology in Action, PowerPoint presentations, audio, huh? And here are the presentations they just downloaded. Awesome. Amazing. Mind-blowing. Amazing. So that's course materials. Then we have Windows 10. And inside Windows 10, we have training and an exam. I don't care if you do the training or not. If you already know something, don't do the training. I don't want to waste your time. Jump in, take the exam. If you don't pass it or you don't get a good grade, go back, do the training, right? And then come back and take the exam again. You can take it as many times as you want. It keeps your highest score. I reward you for getting something done. That's like life. Your boss, hopefully you'll end up in a results-oriented, not process-oriented position. A process-oriented position is you need to show up at 8, you can go to lunch from 12 to 1, you leave at 5, this is where you sit, this is what you do, that camera's watching you. Any questions? That's process-oriented, right? And then like when you come back at 1:10 for 3 days and your boss says, so I noticed you're coming in at 1:10, please make sure you're back by 1, great, thank you. Process-oriented. Results-oriented is I'm hiring you to kick ass, if you don't, I'm firing you, okay? 6 months, I want to see some ass kicking. Are you clear? Great, do whatever you want. And then 6 months, I paid you 60 grand for half a year, you better have made me more than that. Results-oriented, right? Same in this class. Work harder. You know, if you're working in a results-oriented environment and your 6 months is coming up and you're looking at how much revenue you brought into the company and it's like 48 grand and you got 5 weeks left, I got to crank some numbers. I'm double timing. I was blowing it off a little bit the previous couple of weeks, but now, I'm working an extra 4 hours every night so I can get over that 60, which is what I'm getting paid. I don't want to get fired. And then 6 months ends and you pulled it in at 88 or something. You're like, okay, cool. I'm good. That's results-oriented. And so in this class, it's results-oriented. Like, here's the training. I don't care if you take it. Here's the exam. If you take it the first time, you fail. Work harder. Do it again. Put in the extra time. Get a higher grade. Get paid more. So those exams are the ones that count towards your score. And to do it, you just click it. And it launches a little module. I don't know if I have all the stuff installed. It might tell me to install some stuff. What are some of the, what do you want to do with your life?
Teach.
What do you want to teach?
History.
Awesome. You're going to go for a doctorate?
No, I don't think so.
You want to teach history at high school?
For high school, yeah.
Cool. What do you want to do with your life?
HR.
Human resources?
Yeah.
What do you want to do with your life?
I'm not entirely sure yet.
Yeah. Follow what you enjoy. What do you want to do with your life in the back corner?
Me?
Yeah.
Teach.
What do you want to teach? Awesome. I love the specificity of that. That was exactly third grade elementary. So, waiting for Pearson.com. Anyhow, this would launch a little simulation. It asks you to do things, and then you do them. I'm going to see if I can get a Maya T-Lab screenshot. Because everything in the world is online, which is amazing. So here's kind of an example, right? Where, you know, when you're doing Excel in Maya T-Lab, it looks like Excel, but then down here it says select columns A through G and simultaneously set the column widths to 12. 89 pixels. So you'd select A through G, and then you'd go to I don't know where that drop down menu is, review data somewhere, and you choose column width, and then you set it to, and then you hit okay, and then it kind of watches your progress, and that's what this would do. If this window doesn't pop up when you launch Maya T-Lab, look in your browser right here in the corner and see if there's a little thing you could click that says I blocked this pop-up, and then say always allow pop-ups from this Maya T-Lab website, and that will make it work. That has cost many people many hours of their life not knowing that. And if Maya T-Lab is still not working, you could come here to support, and we are in Microsoft Office 2013, I'm pretty sure. No, 2016, awesome. And so you'd go to Microsoft Office 2016, and you do set up your computers, and your computer, and maybe if you need more, you could watch some videos. So this set up your computer could help you set your computer up for Maya T-Lab to work better. Okay? So in Word, there are four of those exams. Let's see if this one pops open quickly. We'll give it 10, 9, 8. That's looking a little better. 7, 6. See? Right? And then I do this thing. Start Microsoft Word 2016 and begin a blank document. So I might go down here and just type Word. And I want to start that. And begin a blank document. So here's a blank document. I click it. Cool. Now I've moved on to the next step. See that? And so then I do that step. And if I didn't know how to do this, I'd be like, ah, I don't know how to do this stuff. So I'd close this and say leave. I come back here, Word Chapter 1 training, and I learn all that stuff, and I go back and take the exam. So there's one exam in Windows, there's four in Word, there's four in Excel, there is four in Access, so that's 1, 5, 9, 13, there's two here, that's 15, so it's basically one a week, because there's 17 weeks in a semester. So as you pace yourself, you might just think, I'm going to knock one out a week. Or you might think, I'm going to do them all in the first 2 weeks. And then you go into the exams, and you have chapter quizzes. And you have a chapter quiz, 13 of those. All right, that's about one a week. I'll just do one a week. All right, so I'm going to do those hands-on exams, and I'll do these chapter quizzes. And then there's some hands-on tests. Word, Excel, Access. All right, after I finish the Word section, I'll do this hands-on test. After I finish the Excel section, I'll do the hands-on test. After I finish the Access section, I'll do the hands-on test. And then, there's the final. All right, cool. After I've done everything else, make sure I'll do this during the last 2 weeks. That's my T-Lab. So be working in Canvas, assignments. If you're in the online class, make sure you're also doing Blackboard, you're also doing discussions, and then you got your Maya T-Lab stuff. Orientated? Are you oriented? Yeah. So that's kind of how you do things. Anybody have questions?
So even the tests in the exam section, you can do multiple times, mm-hmm. including the final. Mm-hmm. And you also said something about class discussion being graded?
For the online classes. Here, it's your attendance, which... Any other questions?
Can you start the exams at any time?
Mm-hmm. Okay. Any other questions?
Your email on and username on My IT Lab is your school stuff from SCCD or your own?
So my school email throws a lot of things in spam and then also gives me a lot of spam. I don't like my school email, so just email me there.
Okay, but when we sign in on it, our email, when we sign in on it, what do we use?
Oh, for your email. You'll use your school email, I think. Yeah, I don't know. I'm pretty sure that would be it. Anybody know?
What?
Signing into Canvas. How do you sign into Canvas?
MIT Lab.
MIT Lab?
Your MIT Lab, you have to create one.
Yeah.
And for the Canvas, it's your student ID, first letter, and first name.
Yeah, I think there's...
The first letter and your last name and your birthday.
Yeah, I understand all that, but I just want to know what they wanted.
Here we go.
Which
So the way I found that was I typed in Fresno City College Canvas, and then there's a link here using Canvas. I clicked that, and it brought me to that.
So, IT, do the same thing. Just go in here and ask it, right?
Yeah, and start banging around, spirit of adventure and exploration.
Go in here and ask it. Let's go.
Yeah, and some people get frustrated because they kind of expect it all to work. And what they don't realize is, no, part of the process is an investigation and time wasted trying to figure it out. That's just part of the process. No matter how good you get with computers, like literally, you know, within, I can't remember exactly what it was, but not too long ago, there was like, I spent a whole lot of time doing something, just trying to get something to work, and then afterwards is like totally clear, and I was like, oh, well, you know, now I see how to, you know, it's Adobe Premiere trying to get this little thing to edit, and I'm watching videos and reading things, like, how is that not working, you know? And I just restarted it several times, and then it just started working. I don't know. So that's just computers. They work amazing today. Cool. That's a little orientation.